Hi, my name is Neil W. Schofield, and this is a video response I'm posting to the clip Calling a Bully a Bully. A lot of workplace bullying has been happening out there. It hasn't been real big news, but it is getting to be more in the public consciousness. The reason I'm posting this is because I myself am being a victim of it. Here's my situation. For 10 years now, I've worked for a grocery store here in the Valley area where I call home. Now, it's a big company with a lot of employees to it. Up till 7 years ago, maybe eight, I didn't have much in the way of a problem with working here at this place, of which I am a cashier. My reviews were good. If a problem did come up once in a while, I felt it would be handled in a professional manner and explained to me very carefully about the benefits and consequences of dealing with it. And I took it at that, and I improved my performance where it was necessary. I enjoyed my job. Now, 3 years ago, a new manager took over from the old one who retired. And since then, things have gone downhill in terms of well-being and in terms of happiness, in terms of overall performance at work. Now, it's difficult to say this because I'm not trying to build myself up. I'm not perfect. I have faults. And one of my faults is that I get tired of people treating me like shit. And so I get angry about it and I stand up for myself. Now, I mean, if that's a vice, I'm guilty as charged, but it comes from the feeling that no human being should ever be made to be felt, no human being should ever be made to feel less than who they are. They should not be abused. Nobody has the right to be abused or be abusing others, if that makes any sense to people. So my feelings run very deeply on this because it affects me personally, as it does so many others out there who may or may not speak up. But I urge people to speak up about this. Employers need to be made to understand they have not, they don't have the right to berate or intimidate or go pushing around employees who they feel are targets simply because of their positions. No, sorry. If you're an employer, you have the right to treat your workers the way you would deserve to be treated yourself, with decency and with respect. Now, I know it's a business, and you're not there to be loved, but at the same time, I question whether or not you feel you need to be feared, and this is being addressed towards the employers. Granted, there are some employees out there who are bullies as well, and they should also be dealt with and put in their place. This is primarily towards employers. My message to employers is this: if you are good at what you do, and you can be effective in your job as manager, do you really need to be a bully? The answer is no. So why are you? Think about it. For all those out there like myself who are victims of this, or who feel they are victims of this, workplace bullying or harassment, speak out. You have nothing to lose but the jobs that are chaining you down in the first place. And you may be like me, you may say, well, I don't have another job to go to. What am I going to do? What if I lose this job? I could be in a lot of trouble. Let me ask you this question. What if you lose your health? What if you have to go on painkillers or antidepressants to keep yourself from having thoughts of suicide? Or worse, having thoughts of doing somebody else in because of workplace-related stress and, you know, negativity? You know, what would be worse to lose? Your job, which you can always replace, or your peace of mind and your health, which may never be replaced? There's something to think about for you. What would you rather hold on to more? I'll put it to you this way. I took 3 months stress leave off from my work because I knew if I stayed there, something was going to happen. I was going to blow up. I couldn't afford to do that. Not necessarily from a monetary standpoint or financial standpoint, but from a health standpoint. My health is more important than any job out there, period. Without my health, I can't do a job. I can do nothing. And that goes for everybody. You, me, your friends and family, my friends and family, anyone and everyone who's ever held a job at any time in life knows that if you are too sick to work, you will not work. You can't work. There is no real law in this country that specifically targets workplace bullying, at least not at this point in time. Hopefully, as it becomes more in the public consciousness, there will be laws that are addressed to this problem, and it is a real problem. But until then, unfortunately, there are a lot of people out there who are going to continue to suffer. One thing I want to reassure any of you who are watching this that may be victims of this, as I feel that I am, you're not alone. You are not. I mean, granted, not everybody's going to be able to, step up and hand you a check to replace the job that you've just lost or that you've quit because some boss or manager is being an asshole. And they are being assholes. I won't mince words about this. They're being damn jerks. And they deserve all the ill will that they get towards them as a result of their behaviors and attitudes. But at least you'll have the satisfaction of knowing that others out there have faced similar situations. Some have triumphed over them. Others have lost. In a few cases, some have paid the ultimate price for having to suffer so much. My heart goes out to the families of those people. Who knows if they might not be still alive with us today for lack of a way to effectively deal with it. We as a society need to realize one thing. There is a time and a place for directing any kind of anger. We cannot just simply go bandying it about randomly and think that we are being effective, because we're not. It is part of our makeup as human beings to be angry, yes. I'm not saying suppress our anger. But when you have to express it because you feel threatened by someone who isn't in the same position as you, or because of somebody who isn't quite performing the way you think they should perform, never mind the fact that they are a totally different and unique human being, unique from anyone else in that workplace or in the world. If they're not performing the way you are performing or that you think they should be performing, they're a bad person and they deserve all your ill will that you can direct towards them. Stop being a workplace bully. Got it? You're killing people. Maybe not directly or quickly, but slowly and surely, you're killing them. And you're not doing yourselves a favor. Now, for those who are victims of this, I urge you quite loudly, get help with this. Deal with this problem. If you have to stand up and tell the person, look, you're being a bully, and I've had enough of this. This is bullshit. The worst that can happen is you lose your job. Okay, so what? If they fire you, smile, wish them a nice day, and leave. And go find the job that you deserve to have and that will make you happy. Isn't it worth it? If you can walk out of a job that's treating you like crap, do it. You have nothing to lose. And that means you have a lot to gain. I'm Neil W. Schofield. Thank you for listening.